Ladies and gentlemen, the main event of the evening is about to commence. Brought to you by the Sandy Hook Tavern, just right up the road in Sandy Hook, Wisconsin. Ladies and gentlemen, our lovely Sandy Hook Tavern ring girls have in their possession the Pinnacle Combat Welterweight Championship belt. Ladies, give everyone a look at that lovely little piece of jewelry. In moments, ladies and gentlemen, Cole Williams will challenge Pinnacle Combat Welterweight Champion Jason Pierce for this belt right here. Afterward, be sure you join us at the after party at Champs Americana at the Best Western Plus Hotel on Dodge Street. Don't forget to save your ticket subs for $10 in match play at the Mesquite Casino after the fight and Sunday during the NFL games. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the main event of the evening.
I think he's a good fighter. He's well-rounded, but he's not great at everything. So when he goes out there, you know, I've done nothing but work on stand-up and ground, and I just don't see him beating me in any area. He's going to go out there just like he has every other fight and try and take the guy down and lay on him. It's kind of funny I'm saying this because I'm a wrestler, you know, and I know how that can be, but that's what I think he's going to try and do. And he's not going to be able to take me down, and he's not going to be able to beat me on my feet. So I guess the best thing I've done that I've used from our wrestling is I can control where the fight goes. And I want him to feel the most uncomfortable in whatever position we're standing. You know, if we're standing, if it's in the ground, I want him to feel uncomfortable and not want to be in that position. And I can control that, whereas he can't. So I have full intentions of going out there and keeping it standing and taking him down when I can. He can't beat me in any area. I've got a couple of new sponsors that came on board. The ABS Computer Repair, Gary's Tattoo has always been really great to me. We have Matt Dakins, he's got Hawkeye Cellular, and Tri-State's Chiropractic Care, does really nice work out there. So my coaches are Ricky Cazares and his brother. Great coaches. I love getting there, and I love the mentality that he brings, just in your face. You know, that's what we need.
The sky. a freestyle fighter. I don't really have any forte. You know, I'm not really great at one thing. I've never been real smooth at anything, but I got a lot of will, a lot of heart. I've heard he's a wrestler. I haven't seen him fight, and I heard he's a brawler. So I anticipate him to come out and try to, you know, knock my block off, man. Pick me up and pile drive me through the canvas. Well, Militich camp, yeah, you know, they started out training themselves. It was Pat and Matt and Jeremy Horn, you know, and Fricklin and Robbie Lawler were all teaching each other, beating each other up, piggybacking each other to show. So, you know, over the years, Pat's kind of brought that mentality that, you know, we're going hard on practice. Mondays are hell. You know, if you don't like sparring, don't show up Mondays. And yeah, they have a, you know, routine for us. Pat teaches us things. We go over things and we drill things. You know, he makes us wrestle, you know. He makes us fight. He makes us ground and pound after 2 hours of training, you know, where we put the gloves on and try to beat the crap out of the other guy, you know, while he's laying on his back. So we get a lot of that. It's pretty rough, you know. It is, I'm not going to lie. I didn't have any amateur fights, and I haven't had a lot of fights in terms of a lot of people's records, but it's because training at a gym like that, every day was a fight, you know. So I've had a lot of fights, believe me. That's for sure. I'm going to try to hit him first, you know, hit him before he hits me, like every fight. Yeah, I'd like to thank Corporate Punk Clothing and Caged Aggression Clothing and Max Muscle Nutrition and Mark Schmall Chiropractic out of Moline. I'd like to thank some trainers I train with in Greg Runge, Ryan Grange, Nick Spone, Chuck Piritz, Junior Hernandez, Sean Huffman, Drew McFedries, Nate Schroeder, Nate Rodriguez, the guys that helped me get ready for this fight. It was a big deal. They didn't have to come in on their weeks off, and they did. So thanks a lot to them.
Let's throw it to our ringside announcer with our main event. Here is Mitch Scott.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the main event of the evening, the Pinnacle Combat Welterweight title fight, brought to you by the Sandy Hook Tavern. It's been a long road for Jason Pierce. Last October, he won the Pinnacle Combat Welterweight Championship. Tonight, he will defend it against the number one contender, Cole Williams.
Yeah.
We'd like to thank the Sandy Hook Tavern for being our main event sponsor. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the main event of the evening. In the red corner, weighing in at 170 pounds, standing 6 feet tall, with a record of 5 wins and 1 loss as a professional, from Dubuque, Iowa, Cole the Spartan Williams! And in the blue corner, weighing at 168 pounds, standing 6 feet tall, undefeated with 9 wins, no losses, and no ties, from East Moline, Illinois, Pinnacle Combat Welterweight Champion, Jason Pierce!
We are set for the Welterweight Championship bout, our main event, Pierce versus Williams. And Nick, as we get going, my question to you right off the bat, does Williams have what it takes to take down Jason Pierce tonight?
Yeah, I think Cole showed in his Debbie Deeds fight a few months ago for the MCC. He can hang with anybody, and his wrestling background is just so solid with his takedowns and control. He can fight with anybody, and he's evolving his stand-up game, and he's always in shape. This is going to be one hell of a fight. And then our champion on the other side of the cage, Jason Pierce, he's still undefeated. He's been fighting for years. Trains with one of the best camps in the world, the Miletich Martial Arts Academy. Let's just ring this bell and get this fight going.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Tape issue. Pierce needed to be taped up.
Yeah, working out with Cole a lot. I mean, his whole mentality is set now. He's ready to move on with bigger and better things. And he's been always just, last how many fights, I think, he's just been trying to find the toughest guys he can. He's had a few UFC veterans. Now he's got a nice UFC standout that was in The Ultimate Fighter. I mean, he just wants the toughest guys, and Cole's ready for anybody, I think. It's all in his mindset. And it's the only way you ever lose a fight, I think. He's got enough skill to match anybody.
We're underway. Round one. Williams in the dark shorts. Pierce in the white shorts.
You know, ever since, like, Cole's pro debut, he comes out and fights, you know, one of my good friends, the executioner Rod Montoya, and just, you know, a guy had way more experience than him, and goes out and takes the win there, and he's just set the pace there, and just, you know, in the middle of a hell of a career right now.
Look at Williams.
Yeah, he looks like he wants to showcase his stand-up now. I know he's been working a lot with Ricky Caceres on that, and Ricky's been talking good things about how good it's gotten, so by the looks of it, usually Cole's right in there trying to get a shot right away and get the guy down. He's looked like he wants to stand up and bang on this one. Kind of look like Anderson Silva a little bit with his hands down there.
Last October, when Pierce won, was crowned our first Pinnacle Combat Welterweight Champion. Yeah, he just showed so much poise in that fight against a really tough former TV man, Bo Loffridge.
He just
looked
fight.
Like he wasn't even trying, you know. And it just looked like second nature to him, you know. He just made all the right moves and took a fight, a tough fight, just took it to, you know, really game of pole.